TFNN. Headline News Update.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow Industrials up 486. That hit a new high out here today. Not holding high, but bottom line, hit a new high. Nasdaq down 209 points. You get the S&P up 6.5. Gold contract down $17.40, 1681. Gold's trying to put in a bottom here, folks, okay? Keeps hammering down to that bottom, keeps rejecting lower price. Equities are basically holding up. Gold and silver equities, this is. Silver down a penny, $25.24 an ounce. Light sweet crude down $1.24, $64.81 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year down 15 ticks, 132.31. 30-year off 15 also at 158.09. Now, both of those also coming into the lows of last week, dramatically lighter volume. Haven't rejected the lower price out here yet, but I suspect that's exactly what we're going to get. King dollar's up by 345 ticks, trading 92.322. King dollar, folks, 92.500 to 93 is game. We'll see how this baby shakes out. The euro is at 118. The yen is out here at 108.86. And the British pound is at 138 to 1 U.S. dollar. We get over and we take a look at the S&P, folks. What you're going to see out here first is that you have some major divergence inside of the marketplace out here, meaning that the Dow Industrials goes to new highs, S&Ps goes sideways, NDX 100, NASDAQ goes down. My take care, folks, is that you have just flipped into a major consolidation, and it's going to get really intriguing, and this is a little change of tune from where I'm coming from. And what I mean specifically is this. We made highs. You come down hard and fast. You get a nice counter trend bounce. We give it up. I suspect we're going to be back downtown. That being said, guess what? We take a look at the SPY. We're at 383. Can you get the 365? Yeah, you can. But it looks to me like this market's going to flip into a consolidation. We'll see whether it's 2, 3, 4, 5 months, whatever that is, because the amount of bread that's coming into the marketplace is big. Market's nervous. You can see it out here in the context of the S&P 500 and more so the NDX 100. Bottom line, S&P can't hold price. That sand wants to go back to the bottom of the consolidation. The NASDAQ is going to give us a good heads up. And I suspect what the heads up is going to be, I suspect the NDX 100 will be the first to test the lows of last Friday. You know, and those lows are the game. And those lows there are going to bring the NDX 100 back to this 12,202 area. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.